Jesus' apostles had miraculous gifts of Holy Spirit, so there was scant reason to raise that question in the first century CE. Although they were anointed by Holy Spirit, the apostles and other first century Christians were not the faithful and discreet slave prophesied by Jesus. It is reasonable to conclude, then, that Jesus appointed the faithful and discreet slave over his domestics during his presence, the conclusion of the system of things. Who really is the faithful and discreet slave? Jesus was referring not to an individual, but to a composite slave, a group working together as one body. Jesus said that the slave, one, is appointed to a supervisory role over the master's domestics, and two, gives the domestic spiritual food at the proper time. From 1919 on, there has always been a small group of anointed Christians at the world headquarters of Jehovah's Witnesses. They have supervised our worldwide preaching work and have been directly involved in preparing and dispensing spiritual food. In recent years, that group has been closely identified with the governing body of Jehovah's Witnesses. The evidence points to the following conclusion. The faithful and discreet slave was appointed over Jesus' domestics in 1919. That slave is the small, composite group of anointed brothers serving at world headquarters during Christ's presence, who are directly involved in preparing and dispensing spiritual food. When this group work together as the governing body, they act as the faithful and discreet slave.